on, guys? Welcome to Chippewa Crown Sports Academy. Coach Andrew here. Today I'm with all-star Cleveland Indians pitcher Danny Salazar. Thank you for joining us today. And today we're going to talk about what it takes to be a big leaguer. I mean, you've been in the big leagues for about 11 years now?
Almost 5 years in the big leagues and 11 years in the Indians organization.
So can you talk about what's it take to get to the big leagues, and once you're there, like you said earlier that you had a few injuries, and this year you were in the bullpen for a little bit and then got to pitch in the playoff start. So can you talk a little bit about that?
Well, first, it takes a lot of discipline, especially when you're in the minors. You have to be really strong because you don't live like very comfortable, we'll say like that. There's a lot of things that are gonna happen to you, but you have to learn those things, you know. And I think you need that as a motivation to keep playing hard. That's the only way you're gonna do it. You have to stop doing a lot of things that you might want to do, you have to stop doing it. You have to rest, you have to eat well, all those little things that you might think like, oh, like this is, it's okay if I do it, I mean, you're gonna do it, but just not try to do it too often, I think one thing I put in my mind is when I signed, it was like, if one day, I won't be playing baseball, it would be because I didn't work hard enough to make it to what I wanted to be. Right now, so far, I've been in the big leagues for almost 5 years. I haven't said yet, like, oh, I made it, because I think I'm gonna say that word after I play at least 10 years in the big leagues, and it's really tough, it's really hard. I have been through a few injuries, one in my elbow, 2010, that I was 12 months out, and that I couldn't throw a baseball, and then last year, my elbow again a little bit, but it wasn't that bad. At least, maybe not last year, 2016, because right now it's 2018, so. And, because of that, I couldn't play the last month of the season, and I came back for the World Series, when we played the World Series, and I couldn't do my role the way I wanted to do it. That it was as an starter. I have to go to the bullpen because I had a limit amount of pitches to throw when I was in the game.
Now, what kind of mentality do you have to have going through not playing for 12 months and just rehabbing and working hard and going from playing every day in the big leagues to not playing now? Working hard to get back.
Yeah, you have to stay positive the whole time. And not just like being positive, because a lot of people, they just say like, oh, if I have a positive mind, like everything is gonna work out great. But you have to be positive and you have to try, you have to do it. You just can't sit in your couch. I think I did everything I can to get back, calling friends that they had the surgery before, asking them questions, working hard every day, doing my rehab program the way the doctor told me to do it. Sometimes it's boring because I like doing the same thing every day over and over. It's kind of boring, but you have to do it. And stay strong. One of the hardest things is like when you, after a month, you see everybody going out, playing, running, doing stuff that you can't do anytime, injuries start getting a little bit frustrated. But you know, I think you have to take the positive out of it. You have to work really hard. That if you do, you're gonna take a lot of battles of it. Like me, I was going 94, touching 95 sometimes, you know, when I got the surgery. After that, yeah, my rehab program, I came back stronger, throwing 98 to 100. So, you know, but that wasn't because I just sit on the couch, like, yeah, doing my rehab, you know. I was working really hard to get that.
Well, the other question is, being an all-star pitcher and you got that pressure that you're one of the best in the game, what's it like having that pressure and then also playing in Cleveland, which is a big city, and you're not always, but you're one of the top teams most of the years and in the playoffs, in the World Series?
It is a lot of pressure because you think like after that you have to do everything right, and that's a lot of things that you put in your mind, and like everything don't work the way you want, and you start getting frustrated about it, you know. And, but I say, like, I said to myself, but that happened to me, you know, like, you have to let it go, you know. That's an all-star grade. You went there because you earn a place, you know, you earn it, and that's why they choose you. But after that, it's like a new game again, you know? The same game, but new, like, forget about what happened. Short memory, you know? Don't try too much. Because the expectation, like, they go really high after that, you know? And if you start thinking about that, it's like, you know, being falling down into a hole that is gonna be hard to climb up again.
All right, thank you. I wish you best of luck this season. As you, how many weeks left? 5 weeks before.
Yeah. Yes. I'm planning to report to spring training on February 1st.
Okay.
So.
As early spring training. Yeah. Getting his work in there.
Yeah. Always. I try to get there always like 2 or 3 weeks. Early. And every year, so you know, there's not much time left to me.
Yeah. Well, I wish you best of luck. Thank you for joining us at Triple Crown Sports Academy. Danny Salazar, check us out at www.triplecrownsportsacademy.com, social media, Travel Ball Team in Orlando. Thank you again.